I have 5 tips for you to help you plan your dream life. So stay tuned. Hello and welcome back to my channel. Today we are talking about your big dreams. This is one of my favorite things to talk about, and today I have 5 steps for you to work towards your dream life. So we're going to plan out your dream life, and I think it's really important to actually have really big dreams, really big goals that you're reaching for, because otherwise we just get stuck in our little comfort zone and we're just going through life day to day. It's pretty much the same thing. If we have something to reach for and we're always growing, then life can be a lot more fun, and the actual journey towards our dreams is part of the fun. It's actually probably the fun part, because when you actually get there, you know, you celebrate for a minute and then it's over, but the road towards your dream is longer and it should be just as fun as actually landing and achieving your dream. Before I get into it, I just want to remind you that the cart is closing for the treasure box for August. So this is the time travel box. If you haven't subscribed yet, then pop over now. The link is in the description below. So pop over there and make sure you're subscribed, and your box will be sent to you at the end of the month. I'll talk about what's in the box in a little bit later, but for now, let's get into the video. Okay, so step one. This for me is the most important thing. I want you to take a notebook or a really pretty piece of paper, and I want you to start a 100 things list. Now this is your dream list. This is going to be a list of things that you want to do. Keep it precious. Put it in a pretty notebook or somewhere that you're going to give it some importance. Now I've talked about this before and I haven't really talked about it in a while. I try to do this every new year. Sometimes I only get to 50 and I'll just bring things over from the year before. A lot of the times there's things that are going to be on there from the year before, but keeping a running list of 100 things that you want to do will help you stretch, reach out of your comfort zone, and go after a life that you really, really want to live. Now you're not going to come up with 100 things in a day. You might, but more than likely you're probably going to take a few days, a week, couple weeks to finish it. The reason I want you to get to 100 is because those first 30 or 40 things are going to be the things that you think you should do, or the things that you have to do, or everyone wants a house and 2 cars, so I'm going to put that on my list. But once you put all those down, then you get past what I call the shoulds and the have to's, and you get to the really juicy things. Don't hold back. Think of the things you wanted to do as a child, for example, and just really dream, because this is your dream list. So dream big, reach for the stars, and put down everything until you get to 100. Now, if you find this a little bit difficult, I do have a little workbook for you that you can sign up at the link in the description below. You can print it out, make it into a little notebook, or add it to your planner. But there's still some prompt questions, and they will help you come up with different ideas that you can add to your list. Now, the second step is to go over that list, and even if you're not to 100 yet, I want you to go over that list. Once you get past 40, let's say, once you get past 40, I want you to go over that list and see which ones of those jump out at you. You may just find one, there may be 5 or 6, but what I want you to do is to take those ones that make you really excited, and I want you to transfer those to your master to-do list. Now, I've talked about master to-do lists in a couple of videos before, and I'll link those in the description below, but for now, these are the ones that you're going to work on, and you're going to add different tasks to your weekly and daily to-do list. Step number 3, if you have more than one thing that's jumped out at you and got you really excited, I want you to start with just the one. Put a star beside it in your master to-do list so that every week you're going to work towards it. And that brings me to step number 4. Each week when you decide what you're going to do that week, when you're planning out your week on Sunday, you're going to go to that one big dream and figure out what you can do that week to move the needle forward towards that dream. So maybe you have a busy week and you only have 15 extra minutes. Find something that you can do for 15 minutes to work towards your dream. Maybe you have a slower week and you can dedicate 2 hours. So put those 2 hours in your schedule, in your planner, so that you can make a big leap towards your dream. And even just 15 minutes a week, or just little by little every day, you're going to make slow and steady progress, and you're going to reach your goal a lot faster than you ever imagined. If you watched last week's video, we did a vision board. Now, if you made one, fantastic, but I want you to add something from your big goal and add that to your vision board. If you haven't done one yet, even just stick one picture up on your wall where you're going to see it every day about this big dream. If you want a dream house, find a picture that you love on the internet, print it off, and put it somewhere next to where you make your coffee in the morning. If you want to write a book, put a picture of a little writing nook or a laptop or something and put that up where you're going to see it every day. But if you do have a vision board, add those to your vision board. The link for the vision board is also in the description below. Let me know in the comments below one of the things that you are going to put on your 100 list, whether that's one of the big dreams or something small. Let me know in the comments below. Don't forget that the card closes today on the treasure box. We're talking about the time travel box, and it is so fun because we're traveling back in time. We're joining it with Doc and Marty, and we're going into the future, which is 2015. We're jumping around in time. We're getting different items in our box from different times. It's just a lot of fun, and it encourages you and inspires you to actually take time for yourself. And not only is the mini craft fun to do, but then you get to use this craft. If you watched the unboxing last week, I'll leave the link in the description below. You'll know what I'm talking about. But then you can use that craft when it's finished as another way to take time for yourself. It really is a box for you to take time for yourself, to take care of yourself, and spoil yourself. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe. Next week we are back with some functional planning, so stay tuned for that. It's a little bit nitty gritty. Don't forget to subscribe and get your treasure box. They'll be shipping out at the end of the month. Welcome back to your channel. Okay, forget that. For the YouTube channel, you can subscribe here by clicking on my little face. Here are two more videos that I think you'll like. If you made it this far, put the rainbow emoji in the comments below. Have a fantastic day and happy planning.